Hello, you're watching KC News. Today, Serda Girt is with you in the studio. The integration of blockchain technology into the medical profession is a crucial moment in healthcare, which will surely lead to an improvement in quality of patient care. Today, we have the opportunity to speak with Katherine Kuzmeskas, co-founder and CEO of SimplyVital Health Project. Hello, Katherine. Nice to see you in Kolesko's new studio.
Nice to meet you. Thanks for having me.
Our first question is tricky. Do you intend to get allies in the form of medical institutions at the state level? If yes, with whom? Are there preliminary agreements on joint work in this direction?
Yes. So you asked, do we have allies in medical institutions at the state level? And yes, with whom? So this is something that we're definitely focusing on. It's important to have those relationships. So with Health Nexus, it's open source, which means that anyone can work with it, anyone can develop on it from here in the United States all the way globally from there. So really that's why we made sure that it was open source, was so that it could be open. At the state level, there are very specific differences, very specific cultural differences that need to be noticed and taken into account. And so since we're focusing on the United States, that open source focus of Health Nexus makes sure that our product is culturally sensitive.
Your project is conceived as global, worldwide. How do you intend to tackle the problem of different levels of medical laws and the different knowledge of medicine in different countries?
Yes. So this gets back to that allies question as well. So since we're open source and since our focus and our background is in the United States, that's where that open source is so powerful. Again, the healthcare is very cultural. It's very sensitive to where it is in the community. And so that's why creating partnerships globally is so, so very important. One of the things to mention we've been asked before is the difference in technological adoption across the globe in healthcare institutions. And one of the good things, obviously, is that we're not going to reach 100% adoption globally on day one. Of course, we're going to be focusing on those communities and those healthcare institutions that are ready to go right now. For us, we already have revenue generation with one of our platforms, and we're focusing on specific institutions that are ready to implement our technology right now. So I think that's really, really important that, yes, there are specific laws, yes, there are specific ways that medicine is practiced globally across the world that differ, and that's where we can really leverage our connections globally, the fact that it's open source, and then we can really leverage our background here with the United States.
Sounds good. Do you plan to connect medical insurance funds to the project?
Yes, so we do intend to link health insurance through our Health Nexus protocol. And this is key because when folks think of blockchain and healthcare, usually the first two directions that they think of, one is electronic medical records and data sharing, and the other is actually health insurance payment distribution. And so this is a very, very strong focus for us as a company. We're already in development. We're working with one of the nation's leading health insurance companies to code a smart contract that would allow them to distribute their payments for something that's called a bundled payment, which is our core focus. Our overall focus is what's called value-based care, which is where providers are reimbursed for the quantity of the healthcare that they provide, the quality that they provide, not the quantity. So it's based on outcomes. With this bundled payment and using a smart contract, what we're doing is we're actually front-loading the smart contract. And as the patient moves through their care, that smart contract will automatically release based on quality outcomes and protocols that they've already established with the health insurance company and with the provider. So absolutely, this is a huge focus. We are being approached daily for how to make that connection in with health insurance payments. Yes, it's huge.
In your white paper, it is said that medical institutions spend $12 billion a year on the exchange of medical documents. This is truly a colossal figure. In addition, health data are sometimes late for 3 months and even for 12 months, which is completely unacceptable. Will you rely on the US legislative base in your work on this issue?
Yes, yeah. So wasting $12 billion a year on the exchange of medical data is astronomical, as you said, and the delay in getting the data in the healthcare records to patients between institutions is unacceptable. So we absolutely agree. One of the things to consider when transferring healthcare data, particularly in the United States, and we've actually confirmed this with our partners globally as well, is that interoperability or sharing of data is actually a business issue, not a technology issue. And what I mean by that is that there has to be aligned financial incentives to share that data. This is a lot of the reason why it takes us so long for us to get our health records when we ask for them. This is a lot of the reason why providers actually don't talk to one another, even though they have you as a shared patient. And that's very strategically why we are focusing on this value-based care. And value-based care, again, is where the providers are reimbursed based on the quality of care that they provide, not the quantity, not the amount of procedures that they do. And so because we're coming into this value-based care model globally, this is a perfect opportunity to leverage blockchain technology to facilitate data transfer. Legally in the United States, when I, as a patient, request my health records, the provider has 30 days to send that information to me. 30 days is still a really, really long time. Since we're focusing specific on value-based care, we're focusing specifically on those programs that have a financial incentive to share data, both with providers and patients. So yes, we are relying on legislative support programs that are in that value-based care umbrella so that we can make sure that there's a facilitation of data sharing. So it's, yes, it's legislative, but it's also in the private health insurance side too.
Blockchain technology allows to build a dialogue with the drug manufacturers. What steps are being taken in this direction? Do you see interest from drug manufacturers? If yes, in what way?
Yes, there is a very strong interest among drug manufacturers here in the States and globally for leveraging blockchain technology. And specifically, it's around supply chain. So supply chain, everything from tracking the development and production of drugs here in the United States, but also globally. And there is a massive opportunity for supply chain tracking pharmaceuticals globally. Specifically in Africa, we have been doing a lot of research. There's fraud around pharmaceuticals, meaning that there's kind of a black market of really, really popular pharmaceutical, really, really popular drugs. What's happening is that there's no credibility behind where those pharmaceuticals or where those drugs come from. And this is where blockchain technology can be extremely transformative. For us as a company, for us as SimplyVital, it's not a focus, but with the Health Nexus protocol, the fact that it's hospital and healthcare grade, it's safely adoptable by healthcare because it's a permissioned protocol. There's also, because we have our own token, that means it's incentivized. And so there's a perfect opportunity for digital health companies and pharmaceutical companies to leverage our open source Health Nexus protocol so that they can create a more streamlined, transparent and immutable supply chain process.
We see that you have a team not so big, but powerful for sure. Tell us please, who are that people and who are your advisors?
Yes, thank you. We do have a not so big team, but a powerful team. So there's four of us full time. So I'm Kat, I'm the CEO of SimplyVital Health, and I'm a former hospital administrator at Yale New Haven, which is the sixth largest hospital in the United States. And very simply, I needed our existing revenue generating platform and our Health Nexus protocol, and I couldn't find it, so we're creating it. It's proven to be extremely successful so far. We attained revenue in less than 7 months, which is absolutely unheard of in healthcare in the United States. Most sales cycles are between 12 to 18 months, and we attained two customers in less than 7 months. So we have a very, very strong track record. Before that, my background is in data analytics. I designed and built a care management platform for one of our state's largest community health centers. They still use it every morning to round on, and I have a master's in public health. Our chief technology officer and my co-founder, Lucas Hendren, is an award-winning software developer. Not kidding. He's a full stack front-end, back-end blockchain developer. Absolutely incredible. Built his own operating system. This kid, he's an absolute genius. And then we have Jake Dreyer, who's focusing on our growth and business development. Jake and I have a parallel background where we were part of Teach for America, which takes the nation's top performing college graduates and asks them to teach an underperforming community in the United States. It's actually more selective than Harvard Law. And so he did that first straight out of college and founded his own tech company as well. He went to Yale School of Management and then joined our team right after that. He also worked at Goldman Sachs for a while and received nation's best sales training. And then our most recent hire is David Akers. He is our blockchain developer as well. He is hard at work, heads down, developing all of our smart contracts that all of our customers have asked for. In terms of our advisors, we do have a very strong slate of advisors. I'll highlight a couple of them. So first, we have Dr. John Halamka. He's the chief information officer of one of the nation's top performing hospitals. And he's also a Harvard professor. And he has successfully implemented a proof of concept from the MIT Media Lab of a blockchain application in healthcare. And a lot of our protocol is actually paralleling that particular protocol that the MIT Media Lab created. We also have Brian Kern, who's a healthcare lawyer, focuses specifically on those risk-based contracts and health insurance. And then we also have some of our board of directors are focused specifically on, in their real jobs, enterprise healthcare sales, which is really, really important because if blockchain and healthcare is going to go anywhere, we all have to know how to pitch this and create a platform that's actually leverageable by hospitals. And then we have Brian Levine, who is a professor at UMass, and he focuses on the entire cybersecurity of their entire campus at UMass Amherst, which is massive. So a very, very strong team and an extremely supportive advisory board.
Healthcare is one of the most important parts of our life. So we are sure you'll catch good luck with SimplyVital Health project. What do you think about one more interview about your project's progress?
So I love to do interviews. I love to be able to get out our message and our mission and our vision. And, you know, we think it's really, really important to continue to push and communicate that Health Nexus is healthcare grade, safely adoptable blockchain protocol. And that's really, really important. Everybody at this point knows their mind almost immediately went first to electronic medical records in blockchain. It's a perfect marriage. It makes perfect sense. But you have to have the right protocol. And so being able to do interviews and podcasts and get our message out there is extremely, extremely important. So more interviews, the better.
We wish good luck to your project and good health to all of us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure. It's nice to meet you.
Thank you, Katherine, for the interview. It was Katherine Kuzmeskas, co-founder and CEO of SimplyVital Health Project.